talking very briefly about a lot of people call consultants the dark side. And I would say that although a lot of consulting firms do have a reputation for being, you know, let's just be blunt, being unethical, I am extremely fortunate in that my company and the person who runs our company has always made it very, very clear that the science will hold me back. And if the client doesn't like the science, then you tell them to take your name off the document. You're not going to back it. You won't testify for them and you won't support that decision. So I would urge you, if you're going to interview with anybody, check in with the ethics of the supervisor that you're interviewing. It's no secret that a lot of agencies, particularly, I hear mostly about it in the United States, are being pressured to change their decisions. So it's not limited just to those of us on the quote dark side. And I know of several reports that where my company has done multiple year research, and the research showed something that the client didn't like. And my boss said, well, that's what it says. And if you want us to change it, then you'll have to have your own people change it, because we won't change it. And I enjoy working for somebody who has that kind of backbone. As far as getting a job in consulting, because it is very project driven, and also because my office is pretty small, there's only 8 people in my office, and we have 2 wildlife biologists, 2 fisheries biologists, some cultural resource folks, some GIS folks, and it's important to be able to work with different people and also to be able to work at learning about different disciplines so that you can fill a need on a project. And I'm not saying that you can work outside of what you know, but it is important to be open to learning about new areas. When you're in your master's program, you get really focused in on the one thing that you're studying. And when you get out and do a job with anybody, you start to appreciate the broad applications and perhaps the specifics that you learn. So just opening your mind to that. And Jack mentioned communication. It's very, 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 very important that you are able to communicate about your discipline to other people, whether it's in writing, if you want to get a job in consulting, I would strongly advocate that you work on your writing. It's also important to be able to communicate that to any lowlife. Be able to talk about your interests and the specifics of your project to lay people, be able to talk about it with agency people, and just be able to communicate and possibly bring people together, different agencies. I work on a lot of interdisciplinary teams where you've got different agencies who don't agree on things, and just helping to build that consensus by communicating the needs of the project. And a lot of times we get called on to be sort of the objective voice in a negotiation, to just present the information. So communication is key. The other thing that's been really important in my job is I've had to learn about the laws and other regulations that affect the resources. If I have to talk about, use the same example, about a bridge on a road, what permits have to be done, what are the requirements on those permits? This all sounds really boring, but if you want to make a difference in terms of whether or not that bridge constricts water movement and messes up the stream and prevents those fish from getting through, or you want to be effective at getting that bridge as wide as you want and making the best decision for the resource, it's important to know what you can and can't ask for, and who you need to talk to about maybe pushing that permit so that, yeah, we do want to acquire, we do want fish passage, we want these things to happen. And then as far as getting a job goes and the outlook, it's like getting any other job. You need to be persistent. You need to communicate why you think you would make a contribution to the firm that you're looking into. Do a little research on that firm. My firm's really small. We tend to focus on a couple of different areas like hydropower licensing, salmonic research, bathymetric river research, and National Environmental Policy Act projects in the West. And the more you can find out about the company to which you are applying, the better you'll be able to make your case as to why you'll be a viable asset to that company. And the economy in the United States is definitely declining a little bit. I'm fortunate because my company only